Hello, Gundam fans, this is Brown92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade Zaku 1 Thunderbolt version, or Old Zaku. Now, this is a completely new mold of the Zaku 1. Very cool color scheme, I really like it. And it has a lot of different looking pieces, especially the backpack. This backpack, this is how I feel you should do fuel tanks, because you got the it's just going on the side, it's not sticking out the back. It's sometimes okay if it's like the Sazabi, which has smaller fuel tanks, but when it gets to like that high mobility Zaku 2 Thunderbolt, which has huge ones that go like to here, that's ridiculous. This is a really compact way to do it. And it looks good. It has a lot of little thrusters, which do... You might want to glue them, because they will fall off. Quite a few little stickers, like the Monoeye sticker, all the little orange verniers in the chest and in the legs, little beige on the kneecaps, all the beige on the shoulder armor, little spots on the front skirt. You got quite a few little ones, little triangles on the feet, ones on the elbows here. I think that little black one's here in the back. I think that's it. There's probably more. But you also have a sheet of marking stickers to make it look more detailed. But I like it like this. It looks really good. I love the, once again, the material looking joints. Even carries onto the top, and it does match the hinge in here, which I really like, so it looks like part of the mold instead of just like a hinge. So they did a good job on this guy. I really like it. Aside from the thrusters here falling off a little too easily, it is a very solid, good-looking kit. I really do like, I don't really care for Zaku ones, but I like this one. Now the head will go up and down and forwards back. It even has the material in the neck. It covers the neck joint. Really cool. Can rotate. And it also has the little hinge or little peg, so you can actually rotate the eye. Really like that. It's a very simple little system they have going on there. Arms can go forward, and they can go all the way around, and out. The shoulder armor can move out of the way, so you can do that. This one easily goes out. That flap can move for whatever reason. Rotate below the shoulder, one joint at elbow, ball joint wrist. Stomach's really nice. It's got a ball joint in there. And there's enough give to get some good wiggling. Which is good because the waist doesn't really move at all. It's a bit like that. Front skirts you can separate. Hinge side skirts. Legs will go forward and back, separate from the waist. And move forward. Not much back. Out. Rotate at the hip. And double joint the knee. And the feet can go forward and back. And side to side at the actual hinge in there, and then they're ball jointed at the foot. And there's also some flip-flop action. So, decent articulation for the Zaku here, for the old Zaku. You can do some pretty good poses. You can get that whole shoulder bashing thing going on that the Zaku one loves to do. So articulation for the Zaku is pretty good. Now let's get the old accessories out of the way that we've seen several times so far in the Thunderbolt line. You got the bazooka, which has a sticker there for the scope. You got the movable handle, main handle, peg on each side, and it doesn't actually use this hole here to peg in, because this is what it would go onto the big thrusters of the other Zakus. I really like what they do, actually. It pegs using these clips, and it actually pegs onto the bottom of the handle. Right like that. So now you hold it like that, which is a cool idea. It does stick out a little bit, but I like it. It's different. And you do have the left and right trigger finger hands with the hole, so it'll hold either one in the hand, which is a good idea. And then you have the machine gun, movable handle, or scope handle, and let's put the hand on here. Once again, peg on either side, so it doesn't matter what you do. You can be a lefty or a righty. Like that. Once in the hands, the pegs, the ball joints are angled, so the little stock here can clear the hand, which I like. And this also can be clipped onto the fuel tank here. Right, like that. That's a little weird with the hand on there. There we go. And, of course, you have, there it is. You have the Heat Hawk, which is the new version, which doesn't have a peg on it, so it looks a little cleaner. And you might be wondering, where are we going to peg this? Where are we going to do it? I love what they did here. See this little indent here? It looks like a vernier without a sticker. You actually get a little adapter piece that you just push in there, and then it'll fit the actual Heat Hawk, and it's pretty snug. It does come off easily enough, but I don't find it falls off too easily. I'm sure it will if you start fiddling around, but it looks good. So those are the normal accessories that we usually get. Now the other ones, well, we have a new bazooka with another sticker. I really like this ammo clip so that you can actually see it. Separate orange piece. Very cool. Movable handle, main handle, peg on either side. So once again, let's get the hand back here. And we'll... Since this is a new bazooka, we'll see how it works in the hand. So just... Freaking dog here. Come on. Alright, so... Just put it on into the hand. And there we have it. Pretty nice looking. I like the light gray. It definitely stands out. Also, you might notice on the backpack there's a little clip here I put on. And, come on. You have to take the backpack off, really. It's hard to get at it if you don't. But, you can take the bazooka here. There's a little hole. And you just peg it right in. Best idea is to move the scope down. But you can peg it right in like that. And then just peg the backpack back on. And it's kind of sandwiched in there. Although if you hit it, you're going to have to take the backpack off again to peg it back in. Because it's really hard to move around in there. So those are the other accessories you got. And put that back on there. So he can hold all of his weapons, which is awesome. But there's a few more things. You've got two crackers. I think they're called crackers. They're basically grenades, I think. The Zaku, that 160-scale Zaku and Build Fighters was using them. And they actually have peg on. Each one has a peg. You can connect them. So if you had a lot of these, you can just peg them all in and have a big cracker field. And just like the Heat Hawk, you get an adapter piece, which fits into here. On this side, it probably fit on the other side too. So you do it like, get on there. So you, come on. There we go. Peg it like that, and then you can use the other peg left over and just peg it in, and it mounts the crackers. Once again, it's a really cool idea. And also, there is this claw back here. Now, the claw. This is the compact version. It's like the other claws, the ones that are on the top of the backpacks of the other Zakus. And what you do, unpeg it. This is, once again, the compact mode. And you bring out the extended mode, which has an extra joint here. And it's a little limited. Really gotta have to take this off. You see there's a polycap in there. So you peg it in to the back. And you can really only have it at the best, I'd say, like that, right against the body. Which isn't a bad thing, but it's very hard to maneuver. So you're just basically, once you get it there, leave it like that, or flip it to the other side. And with that, you can take, well, the bazookas, or the machine gun, doesn't matter which. Actually, let's use the machine gun, because it's going to be very hard to get in there. Now you can just clip it in like that. And now you can use that at the same time. So all of a sudden you can have a bazooka in each hand and the machine gun here. Which is, once again, a really cool thing. And I should mention before I forget, he does have an open hand for the left hand, and for some reason he has another trigger finger hand. Not 100% sure why. I suppose he could have every weapon in every hand, so you just swap them easily. Maybe? I don't know. And finally, yes, there's a little bit more. These little pieces here on the feet, you can actually take them off. And you get open ones. So you could, like, claw on, I guess, to an asteroid or something. Or maybe, I don't know if they'd work on maybe, like, grabbing a hand of a mobile suit. Probably not, but, like, to grab onto something, like, to plant itself better. Which is a cool idea. I like that a lot. It's mostly probably for, like, a diorama if you're gonna ever use it, because obviously he'd be very unbalanced with these. But it's still pretty cool. And I can't seem to find where the actual other piece went, the cover. And it's around here somewhere. But those are the accessories. That's a lot of accessories for a Zaku 1. And I really like it. I like the machine gun and the bazooka we've seen before. They're okay. I really like the new bazooka. I like how they mount the crackers that they have and the heat hawk. It's pretty cool. It is an adapter piece you have to try not to lose, but it's cool. And I like how they mount the other weapons. It's really neat. So everything about the accessories, I think, is really good. Well, I was able to find the part on the foot. So let's compare the old Zaku, which is the new Zaku 1 mold, with an older version. Here is the Black TriStar Zaku 1. And it's quite different. It might not be evident on camera, but this thing is way better than this old Zaku. The old Zaku here I like, but I hope they take the engineering off this guy and put him into this one and make a new Black TriStar Zaku 1, because it is really, really good. It doesn't have double-jointed elbows like this guy does, which is interesting that they left that out. But really, I think it's also because of the mold with the, making it look like it has the material in the joints, and I don't think a double joint would work too well with that. But everything else is really good in comparison to this one. So this old Zaku, I wasn't really looking forward to it, but I gotta say, I like it a lot. I love the colors. Accessories are good. Articulation's pretty good. Overall, it is a good Zaku. And it's nice to see a variant of the original Zaku. So that is about it, and I'll see you at the next review.